I think it was a very good thing that the whole process started from the process of informing the public started from the parliament. As you are perhaps aware, over the last, shall we say, anything between 24 to 36 hours, we had some reports coming out from, you know, Chinese state-sponsored media like the Global Times and others. So there were some inputs which were coming out, and just as they were picking up momentum, just as well that the Defence Minister, Shri Rajnath Singh, chose to make a statement in the Parliament, which to my mind was a very, very substantive and comprehensive statement, in which I think he made it pretty clear that we are not at all getting away from our fundamental position with respect to the LSE in Eastern Ladakh, i.e. status quo of April 2020. So that, I think, has made it very clear. The second point which he made it very clear, and I think I was quite amazed to see the details that he was covering, that the Chinese, the PLA, People's Liberation Army, would remain at the Sirija Fort, and our people would remain near Finger 3. The Sirija Fort is finger number 8, Finger 3 near the permanent position of Thansing Thapa post. So if that is the kind of minute details with which the Defence Minister is communicating to the country, to the parliamentarians, it shows that yes, there is a good understanding of the ground situation. And that said, yes, there are some genuine concerns about, you know, what about Depsang, what about the other points of dispute, Galwan and so on. And I think the Defence Minister did say that it will all be done in a step-by-step manner. And again, I go back to what I said, as long as we are insistent that we go back to April 2020, I think we are doing a pretty good job. I mean, let's not forget even for a moment that the resolve, both political and military resolve that we have seen in our conduct along the LSE has been of a very high order. It has definitely, you know, inspired many in the country. It has inspired many outside. So people have started recognizing the fact that India decided to stand up to what was a sort of mis-endeavor by China. So now I think if this phased manner of disengagement were to take place, and it is also, you know, too much to expect anybody in the uniform or otherwise in the country to trust China after what has happened. So I think that there is no question of the trust coming back so soon. They have to do a lot more to regain that trust. And yet, I think the larger question will still remain. Of course, there are any number of writings, any number of analysis on what could have been PLA's intent, what could have been China's intent. So that must continue to get analyzed as we go forward. And why that analysis is important, because I linked with this, you know, why did it happen, to this business of trust. I think we have to exercise much greater caution now that moment the summer comes, and we should be looking at the entire line of active control with China to be sure that, you know, they are not able to take advantage at any other place, because, well, there are people who suggest that this action has been done more at the behest of China, because they were feeling the pinch of the winter more than us, because our troops are so much more, you know, accustomed to high altitude warfare and stuff like that, and theirs weren't. So that is a statement of fact where nobody can deny that. So the question is, what will they do by the turn of this winter? So that, I think, is going to be important to see elsewhere. At the same time, I think it remains to be seen how prepared we are that should a situation like this happen in the future, we must do something that forces the PLA to react rather than the other way around. So I think those should be the major takeaways as I look at it from the very sort of, you know, comprehensive and very clear-cut statement that the Defence Minister has made today in the Parliament.